Hello, beautiful ones. This is Miss Arkeitha, Soul to Soul Connection, coming to you with Scorpio. Hello, my beautiful Scorpio. This is your timeless reading. So whenever you come across this reading, it is for you. Yes. So all of these messages may not resonate with you, but the ones that do, please go with them. These are your angels, your ancestors trying to get you messages. But they've been trying to get into your hard head all along. You won't listen. All right, it's been a while. I'm trying to get back in the swing of things. You know, it's always things that happen that knock you off course. We're going to keep on moving. It's always an option, right? So, camera not want to work right, but that's okay. That's all right. We'll use the phone. All right, so I've already shuffled the cards. I've already laid them out. Please, if you haven't done so, please make sure to subscribe. Hit the subscribe button and the notification button, bell, so you will be able to get these messages as soon as I upload them, okay? And please make sure to like and comment. Let me know if any of these messages resonated with you, okay? All right, thank you. All right, so I've already saged the cards, meditated, and shuffled the cards. So I'm going to start turning them over. Let's see what's going on with our Scorpio. And I've already kind of got like a go with the flow vibe. Like you're just really letting things fall, the cards fall where they may. Where they may, okay? So Scorpio, the messages that I had got beforehand is that, you know, you're just really going with the flow of things right now, which is really in key with the cards that I pulled, right? So the first card that came up was the trust card. Trust card. I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. And again, that's the same thing that I was feeling like before. I was like, I knew I wanted to do Scorpio. It's just like right now, though, I just feel like everything is just, they're just going with the flow of things. They're just like trying to let the universe handle everything. Like divine timing is the feeling that I was getting. And so paired up with our eternal dance card, movement, will of life, path of least resistance, right? When you, a lot of times, Scorpio, when you're tired of just beating your head up against the wall and you know that's not getting the results and not making things happen the way that you want, you understand that just going with the flow of things, trusting the process, letting the universe do its job is what it's all about sometimes, because just always, it's not, to me, having a plan is good, but it's not always about having a plan. And I think, Scorpio, that's where you're at right now. Really just going with things, trying not to push things because, you know, again, doing that does not make things happen for you a lot of times. Pushing, pushing, pushing and getting the same result, it just doesn't work. So the next card's up is surrender, which I truly feel is what's going on. You're truly surrendering to the process of things. I can release my need to control. And I think that's where you're feeling achievement at. Achievement. Keep focused on your dreams. So what it's saying is keep, if you keep your intentions focused on what your intentions are, the universe is going to bring that energy to you. Positive energy, instead of just always having to try to control it, make things happen. A lot of times you just need to lay back and let things just flow the way they do. And I think that's what's going on right now. I think that the control is what sets you back. I think that people telling you this is the way it should be, this is the way you should do things, this is, you should be there and you should be here, that only makes you want to step back a little more. It's not making you want to say, okay, maybe I do need, what is putting you in a place of, let me just relax here for a minute, let me just observe where I'm at right now, let me just understand that where I'm at right now is where I'm supposed to be, and me trying to force something upon myself, upon my situation, is not going to make it happen. I think it has to do a lot about lost love. I think because that's, and it's about surrendering. Surrender, it says surrender, healing, and release. And again, I think that's what it's all about. Like you knowing that, you know, you can't make anybody love you. You can't make a love situation out of something that is just, is tarnished. I think that a lot of you are going through this right now. I think that a lot of you, and I think this is just more than just lost love as a romantic thing. I think this is just you going in through your mind about people that were there and maybe people that's not there anymore and why they're not in your life and why they're not there regularly and why you don't have a consistency with that. And I think a lot of those tarnished relationships is making you learn about what type of relationships you do want to have, those lost loves. So surrendering to it, not holding on to it, not making it who you are, not falling into it. I think, and that's where the humor card comes in. I choose to focus on the lighter side of life. I think that you're surrendering to those things that has hurt you in the past, and you're choosing to focus look at it as something that is helping you grow as a person instead of just holding you back from something. I don't think that. I think that you feel liberated. That's where the liberation card comes in, because you broke free, breaking free from a negative attachment. I think a lot of these lost loves, a lot of these this guilt is coming from other people that's trying to tell you how to live, how to be. And I think that that's, you know, a lot of times it makes us feel guilty within, like, am I doing the things that I'm supposed to do? Am I being a little bit too laid back when it comes to life? I'm going to say no. Right now, sometimes you have to step back. Sometimes you have to take a breather. Sometimes you have to say, okay, I know that the universe works in my favor. I just have to let it work in my favor. And I'm not going to feel guilty about that. And another thing, I'm not going to let other people tell me this is my life. This is my journey. And I'm not going to let anybody tell me that I'm doing it wrong. And I think some of you are in a place where you have folks that are making you feel guilty about not just pursuing more things and just being so out there. Sometimes just sitting back and watching life that's part of life, learning what this life is all about. And I think that's where a lot of you Scorpios are. Like right now, you're like, I'm just chilling right now. I'm just taking each day as it come right now. And I think sometimes that's okay. Have pride in yourself, because I think a lot of you Scorpios have come a long way. This is a transformation point for you. You got the Amethyst card. Transformation, certainty, confidence. I think a lot of you Scorpios are, you know, getting your confidence back. I think that the last few months have been trying. I think that you've gone through some things with, you know, the people around you that has made you, you know, because you try and try and try. Like, you know, it's about, some of us are those triers that's going to try to make even. We don't want anybody not to like us, and we want everyone to love us, and we try to make everyone happy around us. And a lot of times, you making people happy all around you, Scorpio, you trying to do that makes you unhappy. And then you start feeling like maybe I'm not doing enough. No, be proud of yourself. Be proud of the strides you've made thus far in life. Just because you are choosing to approach it in a laid back manner and trusting the process and not just, you know, and really facing it with a certainty that I know that I am taken care of. I know that I have certain forces that's working for me, you know, and taking it that approach, be proud of yourself. That means that you've been doing the work. That means that you've been doing things that is teaching you that, you know, as long as I keep focused, as long as I achieve things in my life that make me happy, that, you know, I bring joy to others that surround me. It's not always about give me, give me, give me all the time and how much money you have to make all the time. And it's just not about that. It's about the love that you put out there to people. And I think that you are really just trusting. It's about it's just about the love that you're putting out there. It's just about that. It's just about trusting that, you know, that people are lost love sometimes, that everyone is not meant to be there. And I'm not going to let that hold me back. I'm not going to say that it was something that I did every time. It's not always about something that you did. Some people, you just never know what's going on in other people's lives. I think that, you know, you're trying to heal from it. I think that you put your whole heart into, you know, everything that you do for people, everything of people around you. You're a very loving person and you want people to be that way to you. But sometimes you have to liberate yourself from attachments. You have to liberate yourself from certain people because certain people are going to use you for that and are not going to see you for who you are, make you feel guilty when they ask you for things and you just be like, look, I don't have it. Like, or either you may have it, but I'm not going to be the one to give it to you this time because I give it to you all the time and I don't get that same thing. And when I need, it's like I'm not getting it in return. I think that you're really just taking a good look at the people around you, the situations, and you're just really trusting the process. I think you're just trusting the process. And what it's doing is putting you on a path that's not as bumpy and you're just flowing with it. I think you're just enjoying the ride right now. But look at that. Look at that. Let me get that card that just popped out. Oh, gosh. Yeah. You got the inner goddess card. Awaken the goddess within you through dance, self-care, and appreciating your divinity. Which really, that really kind of, like, that is where I feel like you're at. Like you're just enjoying the ride right now. Okay? You're trusting the process. You're enjoying the ride. Yes. Inner goddess. Like, and this is for men or women. I don't care. I'm talking about the inner God. I'm talking about how you're just not letting the news, you're not letting world events change your emotions, change your essence, change who you are, because you know, look, doing that, it's like that inner turmoil that some people have within themselves. I'm just feeling that right now. Scorpio is just really in a place of, I'm not going to let that destroy me and make me who I am, right? No, right. Fairness. You got fairness. You got Mott. First one was Aphrodite. Just like really just cards. The situation would be handled in a fair and just manner. You know what I'm saying? So again, you may have people coming at you. You may have people telling you, like, you know, you just always coming with a negative vibe, just always coming at you, but you're choosing not to interact in that. You're choosing not to, like, again, you're like, okay, I can't make anybody care for me. I can't make anybody love me. I can't make these situations turn out. I can only be the person that I am in it, and I can only go with the flow. If you're leaving me, then that means you left me. If you're here, that means that you value my presence in your life. Either way, I'm going to be fine. Either way, I'm going to really, is this, that's the vibe I'm really getting. Like, and I don't know why all the cards keep popping out on the floor. Like, this is really your card. True love. So when you do that, the universe is saying that true love, Genevieve, that true love that you're looking for, the romantic stirrings in your heart have propelled the universe to deliver great love to you. So going back to the lost love here, whatever you've lost will be returned to you and better than ever. You know, the universe wants you to be paired up, matched up, to meet, to intertwine, to luxuriate in those that want to luxuriate with you. I mean, that's the best way I can put it. The universe wants to bring true love, not just people that's there just to get what they want, they can get right then, and then they're out, and then you don't hear from them anymore. And then where are they at? Where are these people? I think this is what's doing, is gearing you up. It's calm, slow down, trust that we have your back. The universe has your back. And then on the bottom card was express yourself. It's the arts. Expressed yourself through creative activities. So, you know, just, you know, do things that make you happy. Do things that bring the brightness out and the light out of you. And that's all you have to really, really concern yourself with. Because other people are always going to have opinions. Other people are always going to want to tell you, guilt you into doing things for them. And you know, at the end of the day, these people do not have your best interests at heart. Don't fall for the okey-doke, Scorpio. Do not fall for the okey-doke, okay? Yes, yeah, just, you know, do things, creative things. Go to, you know, art projects. Go do things, do art, sing, dance. And that was what this card was about, the Aphrodite card, which matches up with this card really good. It's just awaken the goddess within you through dance, self-care, and appreciate the divinity. Appreciate all the beauty that surrounds you. That's what brings beauty in your life, beautiful Scorpio. And I think that's just where you're at right now. That is what I'm getting. That's where you're at right now. You're just really not, you know, falling for the okey-doke. You're really not just falling for just all of this negative energy that's out here in the universe right now and negativity coming at you. It's just rolling off your, you know, your back. Like water on a duck's back. It's just rolling off right now. And that's a great place to be. You are trusting in the universe. And I think that's a great thing. You're trusting in the process. All right. All right. All right. I love it. I love it. I love it. I'm going to leave you right there, Scorpio. I'm going to leave. That's where I feel right now you're at. And I just think if you continue within the weeks going with that, everything else is going to fall out. Information that you're trying to get through is going to come through. And if you're looking for that true love, you meet people in the weirdest ways. It's not always like if you're one that's always trying to go to the club every weekend or trying to do this and thinking that's where you're going to get your love match, it's not going to happen that way. The universe has it always set up in a way that just blows your mind. And it's going to happen in divine timing and divine order. And also when that soulmate, that twin flame is ready for it as well. So it removes badness to bring in the goodness that we all need and deserve in our life and feel in this lifetime. It's all about love, learning different types of love and loving, just loving who we are in the process. That's who we discover. That's how we discover all that is that this world has to give and offer to us. All right. Again, I'm going to leave it like that. I'm going to stop right there. And I just want to leave you, as always, with peace, love, and tranquility, my beautiful ones. Until next time, namaste.